If you're just joining us, here are the 8 things you need to know today. The former Biddeford pastor caught with child pornography has pleaded guilty to possessing sexually explicit materials. But James Napier will not end up behind bars. Instead, he's accepted a plea deal and will get probation. He's not allowed to come into contact with children under the age of 16. He cannot use the internet or social media. And the family of a woman attacked in her home in Buxton last week is now offering a $500 reward for any information that may lead to her attackers. Yesterday, Buxton police released this picture of the victim, Deborah Nani Nielsen. The incident happened last Friday night on Callahan Road. A 21-year-old student, Mac Jackson, a junior at Bates College, was arrested Wednesday morning in Lewiston on assault and trespassing charges. Police say he caused a serious bodily injury to an elderly man who lives near the Bates campus, but it's not clear why Jackson tried to enter the man's home. He's been kicked off the Bates football and lacrosse teams and could face now expulsion. Lawmakers in Augusta wrapped up the current legislative session last night, pushing a few last-minute bills through. Governor LePage signed a bill to remove or relocate dozens of informational signs along Maine's highways. The law goes into effect in 90 days. Lawmakers will return on May 1st for a veto day.
Continuing the 8 things you need to know today, tragedy on the world's highest peak. An avalanche on Mount Everest has killed at least a dozen guides, with 3 others still missing. The guides had gone early in the morning to fix ropes for other climbers when that avalanche hit. Hundreds of climbers are at the base camp ahead of next month's climbing season. And 1 year ago today, MIT police officer Sean Collier was shot and killed, allegedly by the Boston Marathon bombing suspects, in the hours before the Watertown shootout and manhunt. Family and friends are running this year's marathon on Monday in his memory as part of Team Collier Strong. Another credit card breach at a major retailer, Michaels. The arts and crafts chain says nearly 3 million cards used at stores may have been affected. The store is reporting that data was stolen from last May through the Christmas season, but adds there is no evidence that customer names or PINs were stolen. And finally, Facebook has unveiled a new location feature called Nearby Friends. It allows users to see where their friends are and how long they've been there. The feature will be rolled out in the next couple of weeks for both Apple and Android devices.